Hello guys, this is Andy and welcome to my channel. Today we are going to make this pendant. At first it looked like a daisy to me, and then my son came and said, "Oh my god, it looks like a sunflower." So I've changed the name and now it's named sunflower. I have used 18 millimeter rivoli rhinestone and 4 millimeter Swarovski rhinestones in settings. Then you will have to find 12 pieces, and these are 12 O beads. This whole pendant is made with 12 O beads and a little bit of 10 O's, and these are 4 millimeter Bicones. I have used this 020 fishing thread, and because of multiple passages, I have managed to broke one bead here. But so I have decided to keep this one for me. Then this is the back side of the bezel. I have added these little beads because this rhinestone was thinner than the glass ones. This is also crystal glass. It's not Swarovski, but it's crystal. And so after this one, I've made another one. Okay, and this is the back side. I also had to add this one bead. I will show you how to bezel 18 millimeter rivoli and put the link down below where I am explaining all this. And when I bead this one, I kind of came to the thought that if I use crystals in the same color as the petals, that it might look better. See, and now I feel guilty for not using orange petals. This is Indian red Swarovski color, and this beautiful, gorgeous, warm brown coffee crystal. So I have made this one, and to prove my point, I'm very satisfied how this looks. For this one, I have used 11 seed beads, but instead of 6 beads, I've added 5, so it looks pointier. So you can make this with 11 seed beads, but there's a possibility that you will have these pointy edges, and now it really looks like sun. Like the sun and like the flower. I love it. And so today we are going to make a version totally in white. I really want to look that this time it looks like a daisy. I will try to do it. And I have used these are not totally white. These are a little bit like a champagne, and these are jonquil rhinestones. And these are light topaz. It's really yellow and shiny. I love this so much that I was walking around carrying them in my pocket so that I can touch them and take them in my hands and look at them anytime I want. It's such a joy. I love this. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, so I have bezeled this rhinestone, and I will put the link on a tutorial how to do it. And we will continue from where I have finished my tutorial. I have exited through this bead. Okay, I wanted to work with this AB finish. And maybe it will really look like a daisy this time. Let's see what happens. Okay, so I have to pick. Oh, I forgot to tell you about the materials. No, I have. These are 4 millimeter Bicones, 12 pieces. These are crystal Swarovski, 12 pieces in settings like Montes. These are 12 O seed beads, 10 O seed beads, 12 O seed beads. Okay, so I'm picking one white bead. Then I have to pick one Monte. You just have to pick it, you see, like this, from this top part, not through it totally, from the one side to the opposite, but you see through this pointy part, upper part, and one white bead. Come on. Okay. Like this. And now I'm gonna go through my opposite golden bead. Like this. Okay. I will put my rhinestones all the way around. All the way around, all the way around. Okay, like this, and through this top bead. Okay, this is really easy part. Okay, do this step all the way around, and I will meet you here when I add my last rhinestone. Okay, so this is how it looks for now, and now I have to add my last Montes, but before I do that, I will have to tell you where I will go with it. So I will go through this golden bead, then through this white bead, and through the Monte all the way up to exit here at the top of the Monte. Okay, I have to exit here. So you will have to go through this golden bead, through the white one, and like this through the Monte. Okay? And I will meet you here when I exit. Okay? Actually, I think we can do this together. So I'm picking one bead, one last rhinestone. And now I'm going through these beads that I just said. This is a little bit hard to do like this. I'm not sure if you're gonna see anything. So I went through the golden bead. Now I have to go through the white one and through this top part. Okay, you see? I'm up. Just like this. Watch your thread. Okay. Here I am. And this is how our work looks now. Now, it's time for our next step. Okay, my next step. I will have to take one white bead, 1 10 O bead, and one white bead. So this is the sequence. Okay, and I'm going through this top part of our Monte. Okay, like this. You will have to do this step all the way around, but the important thing is don't pull your thread hard. Just place them so they can sit between these rhinestones, and don't bother yourself with the gaps. Okay, just put them here. So, like this. Don't pull. Just let them loose. Okay, don't let them hanging, but just that they are soft. Okay, do this step all the way around and I will meet you here. Okay, I have circled everything and now I'm adding my last three beads and I'm going through this Monty and okay, like this. And now our step, this one, is finished. Now from this Monty, I have to go through these three beads, all three beads. Just exit here. Okay. Now, above all these rhinestones, we are going to make little arches. And I'm picking the same sequence. One white bead, one golden bead, 10-0, and one white 12-0 bead, okay? Now, it's the same sequence that we've just added, but we are going through this path that we've just made, through all these three beads, okay? Like this. Okay. It's easy, just pick your beads, three beads, go through these three beads. Okay. Like this. Okay. Repeat this step all the way around and I will meet you here. Don't worry. We have left this a little bit loose and now when we start adding this, it will become stronger. You will see. Okay, so I'm adding my last beads. If your beads, you just have to pop them up if they just don't want to come out. Okay, just pop them out and it will be fine. So this is the last step and I am going through all these beads. I have to exit through this bead, so I have to go through all these beads again. Okay, you see how they set sometimes, and climb up here. Okay, right here, and this is how our work looks now. Okay, so our next step will begin from here, from this top bead above this rhinestone. Okay, so you can do this part with 11-0 seed beads, just instead of 6, add 5. And I believe that this would look even much better with 15-0s, but I don't have them and that's why I'm using 12-0s. And I think it would look better. But if you are willing to play, go ahead and try it. Okay, so I'm picking 6, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And now we are going to go through this, look, through this lower part of our Monty, okay, and exit here. Okay, I'm not sure how I'm going to show you this. Maybe I will have to zoom. Sorry. Okay, from this right here through the Monty. I hope that you can see this. You see it? Okay, and now I'm gonna pull my thread. Like this. And now I have to pick 6 beads again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I know that you can't see because of this zoom. 6 beads, and from this place, I'm going right here above this next rhinestone. Okay, you will have to do this step all the way around. Just pick 6 beads, go down through the rhinestone, exit here and add 6 beads and go right here, okay? Like this. And you will get your petals, at least one part of them. Okay, repeat this step all the way around and I will meet you here when I add my last 6 beads. So this is how our work looks now. So I have exited right here through this 10-0 bead, but I will have to go through this first white bead right next to it, like this. And now it's time to add our 4 millimeter bicones. I'm gonna pick 1 bicone and 1 12-0 seed bead, like this. And gonna go through this top golden bead above this rhinestone. Okay, now I'm gonna pick 1 white bead and 1 bicone, and I will go through these 3 beads. First bead right next to the this golden one, and went out through this first bead on the other side through 3 beads, like this. Okay, you see, now I'm gonna pick 1 bicone again and 1 seed bead, white one, and going through this golden bead, picking 1 white bead and 1 bicone, and going through these 3 beads. Okay, repeat this step all the way around and I will meet you right here. Okay, just be careful when you're adding, where are you adding? You just have to add your 12-0 beads right in this place. One has to be here and the other one here, okay? Okay, so I'm adding my last sequence. Now, watch closely. This step is a little bit different. It's not just repeating. Okay, so I will not finish this with going through the three beads. I will just go through this one. Okay, like this. Now it's time to make our petals, the ends of our petals, and we will add three beads, and we will go through we are skipping the golden bead and going through this first white bead and through the bicone. Oops, just through the bicone and this one first bead. Okay. Okay, we need to pop this bead up. Okay. Like this. You see, we have a shape of a petal. Now, I'm gonna pick two white beads. I'm here, right next to the bicone. Actually, I exited through the bicone. I'm here, and now I have to go through this top part of our rhinestone. Okay? In our when we were making our petals, we were going through the lower part of it, and now we are going through the top part. Okay? I'm gonna zoom again so that you can see better. Come on, like this. Okay, where am I? Okay, and now I'm going through this top part, just through the top part. Sometimes you have to bend your work, and but don't worry too much about it. In the end, everything will. Oh, no, went through the wrong side. Come on. Why are you doing this to me? I can't see anything. I'm blind. Okay, I've managed to exit. Okay, I'm here. Added two beads. Now picking two beads again, and from the rhinestone I'm going through the bicone and through this first bead. Okay, like this. Okay, now we are adding our three beads again. They are escaping. Our three beads again, and going through this first white bead and through the bicone. Okay, so from the bicone, we have to pick two beads, go through the top part of the rhinestone, picking two beads, and go through the bicone, okay, and exit through this white bead, adding three, and that's the step you're gonna have to make, okay? Do this. If you're having troubles, just wiggle it a little bit, bend it, and adjust it with your fingers. I will meet you here when I add my last two beads here. Okay, so I have added my last two beads, went through this bicone and through this first bead next to the bicone. Now we are going to make our last step. Look how it looks, it's so gorgeous. Oh my god. Okay, so I will have to climb up here, and I will add my loop for the clasp right now, in case, so that I don't forget to do that. Okay, and I'm picking, you can use
five or six, depending on what kind of clasps you have. I'm gonna attach my clasp with the jump ring later, so I'm just gonna make a small loop. If you are using a clasp that you cannot split open, add it right now. Just pick two beads, your clasp, two beads, or maybe three beads, your clasp, three beads. You will know better what you like. Okay, and I'm going through this top bead again. Like this. I'm gonna circle it once more. Going through all these beads. Just like this. And going down. Okay, I have to go down through this bead and through the bicone. Now this is a bead breaking time, so you have to just be careful what you're doing. You can avoid that if you just use 0.18 thread, but no, I like the hard way. Okay, and so I'm exiting right here. Okay, I have to do this fast, so I have to pick three seed beads and I'm going through these beads again. So I'm going through this first bead through the bicone. Okay, now I have to go, just have to go through these beads and exit here, add my three beads, go through all these beads, okay, and exit here to add my three beads, okay, and just be careful. Hey guys, so this is how it looks, and our daisy sunflower is actually finished. I hope that this was understandable to you and that you have liked this project and that you will enjoy making it. Thank you guys, my storage is full and I hope to see you next time. Ciao ciao.